You did it! You're confessing to the murder of Monsieur Greenway!
Not what? No. I have no idea who killed the frog. I'm just admitting that I'm guilty of producing fraudulent photographs. I was ordered to make changes to the printed photographs.
Photographs, not photographs.
Photographs. And yes, that included adding hands to the clock.
You were ordered by who?
Is it not obvious or spewed by the Baron? I dare not say.
Monsieur Robinho, I strongly advise you to answer the defense questions. You have pledged to speak without fear, after all.
With respect, Judge, I fear his claws more than I fear the punishment of the justice system. I shall name no names.
His claws? Do you hear that, Falcon?
That is most unfortunate. Monsieur Robinho, we cannot and shall not torture names out of you. We don't live under the ancient regime, after all.
What does that mean? The ancient Rome?
Ancient regime of, like, just torturing.
Oh, those kind of era. Yeah. Okay.
But since you have admitted to falsify evidence, then we cannot keep you on the stand as a witness. Take your leave. You shall be charged with perjury in due course.
I can protest. That's the least I deserve for my failure as an artist. Good day, messieurs.
Oh, intriguing.
Pretty convincing.
He gave him the favor with the jury. So
the clerk's hands were painted on. So what? It doesn't matter. The photograph still depicts that Kathleen is absent close to the time of the murder. That's significant.
Don't be dense, Monsieur Rabiton. If the photograph is not completely genuine, then it cannot be considered reliable evidence.
Why not? It's still a portrayal of the night's events.
Because if we accept that one part of the picture was edited, then we must accept the possibility that other parts were too. It is possible that Dame Kathleen was painted out. Even worse, it is possible that another person was painted in. We know that the witness was trying to cover for someone, so all possibilities must be accounted for.
So what you're saying, Falcon, that the housemaid who paid off the photographer? Or was it Sidney Pertu, Damian, perhaps?
How are we feeling so, daughter?
I don't think so. The housemaid lacks a means or motive, and it wouldn't make sense for Signor Pertur to implicate his own daughter.
Surely you're not suggesting that the honest and beloved Baron Rocchio deliberately tried to frame Damned Kathleen then? Maybe because that would be the most outlandish theory. Yet the Baron is the pillar of our community. He would never do such thing.
Oh, Monsieur Rabiton, I'm not here to throw accusations. That's the job of you, the prosecutor. However...
Rogue, Mayhaps I should offer my opinion.
Baron, it's not time for you to witness, for your witness testimony yet.
Oh, so you think, prosecutor. And yet I see my good reputation get tarnished by your incompetence.
Incompetence?
Indeed. Let us proceed with witnessing question. Witness question. Is that fine with you, Judge?
Yes, I suppose it's fine.
Very good. And I trust that the defense has no objections.
No objections here?
Fantastic. But before I forget, I pledge to speak without fear, prejudice, etc. Now, prosecutor. Ask me about what I witnessed over the course of the evening.
I just noticed, like, Baron, his mane is like curled very nicely.
Fabulous!
Oh, then I found like something off about him.
Okay. Baron Rocky, on the night of the...
The initial dinner went magnificent. When the photographer arrived, secret we left to visit the garden. Damn Kathleen followed behind me.
Cigars, his. Yeah, it is on. Wait, what?
Yeah, cigar in the fountain.
Yeah, that's what I mentioned. I was like, hey, yeah, that's, can't be like, that's, new.
That's the proof that he went there then.
Oh,
he's
yeah.
He's probably gonna say, like, I never went to the garden. What are you talking about?
Oh, I know, right.
Signor Bruto, but Signor Robinho and myself were engaged conversation, so he paid her no mind. After the photographer had left, my husband left to go find Monsieur Goodby and Dame Catherine. That would be when I heard her cry.
Thank you, Baron. I think we all know for the story from there.
I would like to cross-examine the witness.
Do you doubt my integrity, Garson?
You did not pay me, of course. I doubt you.
Alistair Papa. Very well then. Hit me with your best shot. Let us establish with absolute certainty that I, Baron Rocky, am an honest man.
The defense may proceed with the cross-examination.
The judge sounds so like...
I don't give a fuck what happens to you, I just want to go home.
Oh, I understand.
Wait, when the photographer arrived, Monsieur Gregory left to visit the garden. Okay, that we know. My housemate discovered the pair. What should we ask him? Sorry, please.
Well, I won't say the dinner went magnificently when they have missing cutleries.
Oh, yeah, huh? Hmm. Is there something you should be asking about them?
Straight about the garden, since
there is a possibility like he might answer like, oh, I wasn't there, so they took two.
Yeah,
I should have read the lion's voice in this. Oh, is it the garden? Then could the lady follow behind a few moments later?
Sorry, I love it.
Garden?
I suppose so. I mean, why did Monsieur Grenouille went to the garden? Nah, I think it's just garden. Feels more straightforward to just ask about the garden.
Baron, we saw the murder scene. Your garden for ourselves.
Yeah!
Can I want to know about the horses?
Is this
gonna jeopardize the whole thing?
I'm worried about jeopardizing. If not, it'd be
but
so
I do want to know. I want to know about the horses.
I wonder if it's okay if we save and quit. If we come back and continue. Then we can quit without saving, right?
Okay.
Yeah, quit without saving.
Okay, let's try.
Do you want to try?
Yes, I need to know about the horses.
Oh my god, this is... Wait! We literally just...
But continue though?
Yes, continue.
Did we spend a day or what?
Then we are already at the courtroom.
Oh, okay, just try.
Oh my god! The waffle, it says quick save and quit though.
Yeah?
We didn't even choose low experience.
It says quick save!
Yeah! That is
bullshit. I have qualms about this!
But we do remember our answer lah, so it's alright. Yeah, we chose
low. We'll stick to it.
Oh, yeah, we stick to it lah, okay. Oh, Monsieur, is there anything? Oh, thank you. I'm gonna ask her. Oh, let's go. Oh, yeah, the cool courtroom.
Oh, prosecution is ready.
Ah, let's go. The defense is ready as well. Come on. Oh, let's hold the juries. The prosecution sucks. Oh, is that written? Oh, so in the windows.
Alright, let me look boss.
We chose who blood was right? It. Yeah, because we thought that we could actually continue.
I do.
Do you still want to choose the horses with them?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, I mean, it's not that it's that,
not that far.
Yeah, okay la.
Oh, intriguing. Oh, pretty convincing. Oh, you need to be convincing.
Oh, evidence. Oh, what's this?
Oh, it is a pass. Oh, oh god.
Oh, how could this be?
I don't know if you miss it out at entirely if you do choose like a horseman.
I mean, we can still quit and save her. I mean, we can still quit Wasp. Right. I'm a bit worried because like the continue one, right?
But why the continue?
It's like it's entirely a new day, right? It's not like it's actually.
I mean, it didn't continue from where exactly the point we stopped. Like it's somewhat like restarting this whole case again.
Yeah, I have qualms about this, honestly.
Ooh. What? My photograph is fake. What the hell is gonna come down? Come. Alibi! Battery!
It's so tiring.
But I suppose they don't want you to cheat in that sense as well.
Oh, I suppose so. I mean like, even right now we're already like, Oh my!
But the horses!
You must know about the horses!
I want to know about the horses as well! Let's go! the garden!
Are you sure?
If I may ask, what's with all the horses?
I beg your pardon?
There are all these horses and shrub statues in your garden. To be frank, we found the whole thing a little weird. But the defense, please stop horsing around. This can't possibly have any relevance to the case. Okay, I thought they would have something more interesting to talk about.
Oh well.
Nay, it doesn't, but hey, you can't pay a man for trying.
That rhymes so well. Oh my goodness. Not bad. Not bad at all.
Okay, we can do this.
Yeah, we can do this. Okay, that's good to know. Okay.
Baron Rockwell, when was the last time you ventured into your own garden?
Oh, as it happens, I have quite serious allergies. I haven't been in my own garden.
Yes, you say?
Indeed. That's not right.
Baron, I do not wish to call you a liar, but that claim does not hold up to scrutiny.
Oh, and what is that?
Because we have hard evidence that you have visited the garden recently.
Oh, but anyone could have a cigarette. Balderdash, my word is gone. Show the court this so-called hard evidence that I've been in my garden.
Here is the hard evidence that is quite damp and wet and not hard at all.
It's quite limp, if I might say.
This was found in your garden. To be specific, it was found inside the fountain basin. Right beside where the murder occurred!
Ruff. A cigar butt?
That could belong to anybody.
Prosecutor, please shut up. I can speak for myself. You're incompetent.
Oh, okay. Sorry, Baron.
That is indeed the remnants of one of my cigars. But I must apologize, Monsieur Falcon, for I misunderstood your initial question. You see, prior to the banquet, I hadn't visited my own garden in years, but naturally, after hearing the housemaid's cry for help on the evening of the murder, I rushed outside. I was shocked and disgusted by what I saw. That must have been when I dropped my half-smoked cigar into the fountain basin.
Oh, we didn't even like said that it was found in the fountain basin.
We did.
Oh, wait. Oh, I forgot. You see, Falcon? That's a perfectly reasonable explanation.
I would find that believable if the cigar were casually discarded. But as it happened, the cigar butt was found in the fountain's upper basin, a location that could only be accessed with great inconvenience.
And a little paddling.
The cigar butt was not dropped. It was deliberately hidden. Deliberately hidden.
But you could have just taken the cigarette with him.
It's kind of dumb.
Yeah, it's very strange.
Unless there's blood on the cigar.
Oh, because he was still smoking and killing him, is it? Oh, so classy.
There are any number of possible explanations.
Are they? Because I can only think of one. That is, that you, Baron Brunquill, deliberately hit your cigar butt to disguise your own illicit activities.
Did I now? And what illicit activities would those be?
You want me to spell it out? Fine. Let's put everything on the table. You Baron Rogue murder Monsieur Grenouille. That is what you were trying to get hidden.
I am sorry. Really accusing me of murder. How shamelessly brazen.
That is ludicrous accusation, Falcon. The Baron is an upstanding citizen of the highest order. Your allegation is baseless. You have no evidence, no means, motive, or opportunity.
No evidence? Think harder, Monsieur Remington. Every piece of evidence points to Baron Rumpel as the prime suspect. What's the problem? Businessman as well, right?
Yeah. Of course, businessman.
A colleague of Doyle.
And Rogel. And then Rogel is like, eh? Who is Rogel? A repeatedly ruthless
businessman. What the means? The Baron certainly had the means. His lion's claws are sharp as a surgeon's blade. Cutting from belly would be trivial to me. Even Monsieur Robinho confessed just a moment ago that he feared his promise.
Ridiculous! I would never threaten a man with violence.
You want a motive? The Baron had at least 10,000 francs worth of motive. So much money.
Yeah.
By removing a business partner, the Baron's share of his railway company increased from 1/3 to 1/2.
This is preposterous!
And finally, the Baron had an opportunity. No, he crafted the perfect opportunity. He arranged a small banquet with a very select number of guests. He was aware of the missing silverware, and yet he served steak, a food item that necessitates good company. Why? To bloody the hands of his guests, of course. Then he hired an easy influence photographer, and staged a very specific picture in order to build a perfect alibi for himself. Photographing the guest in front of the headless clock to make the world easier to think is quite an ingenious plan, it must be said.
So I say, like, why is like specifically this part that the clock now has on it?
I'm just going to let the stutterous young go uncontested. Say something. Object.
Aviary! Your objection!
Oh, you're pitifully useless.
After executing the murder, the Baron found himself still holding a single piece of incriminatory evidence. His finished cigar. He knew that leaving it at the crime scene would raise suspicion, but he didn't have the time to properly
dispose. He could just put it in his mouth!
So out of desperation, he threw it into his fountain out of sight of his guests and his
What am I talking about? Putting it in his mouth.
I imagine the Baron was hoping to implicate Signor Pretoy de Miao, since that would ensure total control over his railway. Zen Kasumi was the first to handle the problem, so the Baron improvised.
This is an outrage! Josh, I demand that you disbar this ranting lunatic.
No, there is only one outrage here. That is that a man like yourself is able to abuse his wife and status to frame an innocent girl for mother.
So intense, oh my goodness.
Oh, yeah. You are a virtuous of the worst kind.
How dare you, God, gods of gods. The innocent, the utter nerve of line scumbag of a lawyer to accuse of philanthropists like myself of something so heinous. I'm nothing like the fat cat burger. I'm a respectable, hardworking capitalist.
No, you're a ruthless man who will slaughter a dear friend just to rip a few francs, just like me.
Oh, this is so true. You incredulous wimp! I ought to cut you right here and now like a damn frog!
Could someone please restrain the Baron?
I'm on it, Your Honor. Let's go, woman. Do the concierge.
Don't touch me, you filthy jackdaw! I can walk myself with my fabulous curled up hair.
That is quite a turn of events. Does the prosecution have anything to add?
In a matter of speaking, to be honest, no.
And I should now confer with the members of the jury to come to a decision. I ask that the animals of the court please be patient in this time. Goodbye, my show is on now.
Falcon, that was pretty incredible.
Thank you.
Don't get so full of yourself, please.
I just hope it was enough for the money.
What do you mean? You just proved Catalina's innocence. You'll get a not guilty verdict for sure.
Spurs, I think you've misunderstood something important about the justice system.
What's that?
I haven't proved anything. As lawyers, we cannot deal in proofs. It's just not possible. All we can do is organize the evidence, convincingly explain what to suggest. I haven't proved Catalina's innocence. All I have done is demonstrate that there is a significant possibility that she is not guilty.
I'm not sure that I understand the difference.
Never mind, my show's been cancelled. We have reached a decision. In light of the recent revelations, it is clear that an error of judgment was made in the initial arrest. On that note, we unanimously find the defendant and Catalina Demir to be not guilty.
No?
Oh. Yay! We got them our first case!
Not guilty.
Oh, Monsieur Falcon, Petit Spencer, you did it.
Yes, I suppose we did, didn't we? Now what about the money?
Oh, my papa will pay you. We should head back to the office so we can celebrate properly.
Hush, Patterson! The money's all mine.
Oh, but you did it, Falcon!
It is all mine, I take all the money! You must smile
so I can
get
it, man! Oh no! I'm so proud of you both. I'll go get one bottle of wine and three of at least 30 glasses!
Oh my god!
You are amazing, Monsieur Falcon.
Oops.
Now let's wear band tonight. I'll pay you the money.
But you never told me your bust size.
I very much like the way you pinned the murder on the barrel. That was an act of sheer genius.
Well, I didn't pin anything. Sparrowson and I just worked at... I just worked at unveiling the truth given the facts of the case.
Oh my goodness.
Monsieur Falcon, there is no need to play coy. The case is over.
Play coy?
Don't tell me you're actually being sincere.
I'm completely lost. Do you mean to say about the money?
Oh wow. I thought the goody-goody thing was an act, but you actually don't know. Alright, I'll spit it out for you. You want my bust size? It's 38, 30, 40.
Wait, she's actually a murderer, is it?
I wonder.
I murdered Monsieur Gridman.
What? Oh my goodness.
I saw him in the garden. All drunk and vulnerable. And I seized my opportunity. It was nothing personal. Just business. You understand?
Business.
Oh my god,
we already fucked up.
But this is nice, you said that there is a possibility that our clients are not innocent at all.
And we are just this is so good, it's so smoothly.
It's a... But I feel like...
But also, this is your fault.
But you are the one who gave the evidence. Fuck.
To increase my papa's share in the trade company, of course. My papa always said that the drug or fraud was the biggest thing.
Your confession doesn't make any sense at all. I found Baron Robert's cigar pot hidden in the garden.
Oh, I put that there. I expected the police to find it, but I suppose they must put too much faith in the police of Paris's finest.
But Falcon proved that Monsieur Robinho's photograph was edited.
It was edited. I wasn't in the picture because I was busy paying a visit to Monsieur Gridman in the garden. My
Papa knew I needed an alibi, so he ordered Monsieur Rubinio to pay me over by Rocky and to add hands to the car.
Eh?
Wait? But the song doesn't have an Isla in it.
Oh, that means he didn't have time to finish painting in the hands, and they were all
supposed to have
Because
we either. Stole the picture!
Yeah.
Oh no!
So it's not that there's a possibility that we might miss some clues, but we might have took some clues that will doom us.
But why what?
God. Is this how? Could we have gone to find this case?
It makes me wonder if could we have gone, or like this is how it's meant to be.
Yeah.
Because like we've gotten the evidence and it really aligns, or maybe it's really going to come into plan. You could just say, I don't know, I don't have evidence, and then they could have just convicted.
But I mean, either way, we are defending her, so
it is our job to defend her, ma. Like as an attorney, our job is to defend our client.
Okay, I wonder like how it would have gone if say didn't collect some.
Huh? Then like say like if we didn't actually took a peek at the founder, then maybe from this that she might actually would be convicted as a guilty.
But then what happens to like Falcon's person? That's why I'm confused about like whether or not this team will retain and how that's not the line. Like do they just let you continue on and you just know whether you're fucked up the case or not?
Yeah.
Like you know, in the end it's just like I live a long life and I fucked up every single case.
Oh no, this is too real. I didn't play this game to feel the realness. Anyway, okay.
The artist didn't manage to finish altering either photograph by trial day. It's a good thing that Monsieur Falcon was so imaginative, because that could have gone very badly.
Actually, we did steal the photograph.
And I thought like because she's a lot smaller, so it's actually easier to paint
over, right?
Yeah, rather than you know you have to paint in the background and everything.
Yeah. That's why I wonder if they actually like it's not like they took photo of everyone in, but they actually took a few times. Like to the fact that maybe like
he definitely took another one as reference, like, I mean.
Probably yeah, I mean
they,
like
they sure, did mention that he started the camera at 7 and only at 7:30 he finished taking.
Yeah, and the fact that that's why it's like I feel he never said his claw is like I feel
a cat as well.
Claws, yeah. Interesting. What's if the silence? You should both be proud. There aren't many lawyers in the whole of France who could have won a case like this, even for a burglar kitty like me. I think you should leave. Fine. So much for celebrations. Here's the payment for your services.
No money, money, money!
Straight from my papa's pockets. Well...
Not enough! Stop!
What, so we got like 40 francs. Bless you.
Adieu, Monsieur Falcon. Adieu, Petit Svensson.
Falcon, what do we do now? Falcon? Wait, is this really a game over? It's either we continue or I don't see a point of restarting and we've been through so
much.
Yeah. Hey, this is interesting.
Huh. You know, if we don't win the case, we don't get the money though.
Yeah, exactly.
I wonder how much the money affects down the line.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
The Palais du Louvre.
Oh my god, it's literally a big one. Let us be reasonable, Simulus.
I'm sure this is a simple misunderstanding. There is no misunderstanding. In the name of the king, arrest the spiner.
Whose human hand is that? A fox among wolves.
I do wonder. But anyway, like, if we win the case, we do get money. That's the thing.
But that's why I said I wonder how much, like, the money affects. Like, do we still get to go on?
Yeah.
For any reason to suspect that the blood belonged to someone other than Monsieur Grimby.
We do, though.
Yes! I do, Your Honor. You may now kiss the bride.
Oh my, with the
magic. Actually, I have more than suspicion. I have evidence that the blood on Dame Catherine Paul's had nothing to do with the